అందరికీ నమస్కారం. నా పేరు వినీత.
నా మైక్ వర్క్ అవ్వలా ఉన్నదా?
And our co-host, the beautiful Krishnaveni Vivek Ram. So, yeah.
Thank you, Ka. Thank you. She's gorgeous.
Okay. So, Veni, nu vyadundo chundava, oor edi needi, anni seppu manakandiriki.
Sure, Ka. Na tella andiriki na oor telsnata. Na vachi appenaikan batti londi vachinda. Cement factory, Alangulam pakkala. అక్క మీ ఊరు ఏ ఊరు?
నా ఊరు కోయంబత్తూర్. ఈడ ఓరందరూ ఉన్నారు కోయంబత్తూర్ నుండి, గివ్ ఇట్ అ షౌట్ అవుట్. We have a big crowd representing Coimbatore today. Awesome. Now thank you to everybody.
No. This is not fair. Rajesh anna yana undal note pannukonda Coimbatore vala ooru sepetri emi vishayam anta konja gamanchanda.
Okay, sorry Veni. Maa inti aina ooru Thoothukudi, vala samudram Naikarpatti. Shout out, there's a lot of people here from Naikarpatti. Beautiful place. So thank you Veni for correcting me. anike Veni ippudu mana susi me yoga sumpisiri Guna. Thank you. Indonesia lundi ochi. Those were amazing. I hope meer rep telari ostre adani chestre. Very good for health. So what are your plans? Nu rep ocheva?
Yeah, sure ka. I mean yoga life ki etta important nesi just oka half an hour session la enta baaga explain chestrikadu. So definitely I am planning to come here.
Very nice. Yeah. I have a couple of important points. One, safety, please follow the safety instructions. Me table anni kodi clean chesinda, water bottles unte please throw them away. And we are running behind Veni. So what's going on with refreshments?
Actually refreshments vachune undadi vachesar telsa. So manaku break ta taniga edin redu mana agenda lo unne madri. So రిఫ్రెష్మెంట్స్ ఎత్తుకోండా, వచ్చి టేబుల్లో కూర్చుని ఎంజాయ్ చేసి తినండా, ప్రోగ్రామ్ని వాష్ పనునే తినండా. అండ్ ఒక కైండ్ రిక్వెస్ట్, అతనే క్లీనప్ చేసేయండా. మన ఇంటికి వచ్చి మన చేసి మన క్లీనప్ చేసే మాదిరి తెలుసుకోండా, అతనే క్లీనప్ చేసి పెట్టేయండా. సో ఎవ్రీ టైం కిడ్స్ నూడ్సి చేసేది కొంచెం కష్టంగా ఉంది. అండ్ వన్ మోర్ థింగ్ కా,
ఫోటోగ్రాఫర్ యా గో హెడ్
యా ఫోటో బూత్ వచ్చి నేను ఫుల్గా ఓపెన్ ఉండు, రేపును ఓపెన్గానే ఉండు. సో ఫోటోగ్రాఫర్ ఎప్పుడైనా ఐడిల్గా ఉండే మాదిరి సూతిట తబాట పోయి ఓ ఫోటో ఎత్తుకుని వచ్చేయండా. సో దట్ మన లైన్ ఫామ్ పని చేసి నిండి నేరం వెయిట్ చేసి టైం వేస్ట్ పనవద్దు. సో ఎప్పుడన్నా ఫోటోగ్రాఫర్ ఊరి కూర్చుని ఉండేమా తెలుతుట tappata parthi pai photo tappata ethunu vachenda.
Yes, and today it's a different photo booth, tomorrow will be a different photo booth. So kandipga nendo family photo ethenda and again tomorrow.
Yeah.
Okay nimchunda. Yeah. ప్లీజ్ మీరు అందరు రిఫ్రెష్మెంట్స్ ఎత్తుకోండా, నైస్ హాట్ పకోడాస్, టీ, కాఫీ ఎత్తుకెని వచ్చి ప్లీజ్ బీ సీటెడ్ అట్ యువర్ టేబుల్ అండ్ విల్ స్టార్ట్ అవర్ నెక్స్ట్ ప్రోగ్రామ్.
సూపర్ ప్రోగ్రామ్ ఉంది, సమ్మగా ఉండిపోయి నిండి నేరం వెయిట్ చేయవద్దు మనం ఆ ప్రోగ్రామ్ చూసేదానికి. సో టక్కట పోయి ఎత్తి టక్కట వచ్చేయండా, మనం ఆ ప్రోగ్రామ్ స్టార్ట్ చేసేద్దాం. అండ్ మన కానాగ సమ్మర్ రీచ్ ఉంది కా ఇండియాలో, లైక్ ఐ వాజ్ సో సర్ప్రైజ్డ్. నా క్లాస్మేట్స్ అందరికీ కానాపతి తెలిసింది అండ్ దేవర్ ఆల్ ఆస్కింగ్ మీ అబౌట్ కానా, ఆర్ యూ గోయింగ్ టు కానా, యు ఆర్ ఇన్ డాలస్, ఆర్ యూ గోయింగ్?
Yes, we were all planning to be here today and nitta baagundinda mimmalni andini sosi, we are so your enthusiasm, like meer india lundi vachundaru you know, all over the world. India lindu entha per vachundaru. So idani susi meve ba enthusiastic ga undama, overwhelmed with the love that you have shown over the last 18 months preparing for this. Lots of hard work by all the volunteers, right? I know you were a volunteer too.
Yeah. Min akkanu oka volunteer da. She was responsible for all the decoration, whatever you see here. She's one of the committee member from decoration.
Thank you, Veni.
Nannu konni cheppanda.
Veni Krishna Veni ochi, she was in the reception committee. Anni goodie bag ani fill chesri. It was a long task. Andarki correct ana t-shirts petti, ladies ki gift, biddalki anni books, so informative. Very long nights they have spent doing all that. But bigger thanks to people who sent it from India. While India lundi, you know, they took the pain of sending, packing everything, getting our banners, beautiful banners ready. So thank you to everybody, each and every one of you, each and every one of us, for making this happen today.
And appi pettindi kuda, I mean, excess amount appi pettitri. Like mom first vachina package na susi kuda, like ayyo idi salna salada em cheyapoyamta. When I saw the next day, like packages, ochi, we cannot sort it out. Like extras ninda unda, so feel free if meek t-shirts and mari meek etna size la emna extra undita, feel free to take it.
And also I like that andaru mallipoo pettikinundaru.
Yeah.
Mana oor, you know, feeling ochi ippudu andarni susi telungula maatadi. ఏది సీనియర్ అన్న తెల్లారి చెప్పినట్టు పెద్ద పెళ్లి మార ఫీలింగ్ వచ్చి అందరికి ఇడ
లైక్ రెడీ అయిందే వచ్చి ఏదో మన ఇట్టి పెళ్లి పోయినట్టుగా ఇల్లు ఫుల్లా సుట్టాలి లైక్ ఓ ఇడ డాలస్ ఓర్ ఇల్లు ఎత్తాలు ఫుల్లా సుట్టాలి లైక్ ప్రిపరేషన్ వర్క్ అత్తా సుత్త నేను పెళ్ళి రెడీ అయిన మాదిరేనే ఉండా సో నింద హ్యాపీగా ఉండా మనం ఎవ్రీ ఇయర్ ఇది అటనే కంటిన్యూస్ చేయాలక ఈ ట్రెడిషన్
అబ్సల్యూట్లీ అండ్ బిడల్ కూడా ప్లీజ్ గో అవుట్ దెర్ ఇస్ కోనా ఐస్ క్రీమ్ ఫర్ ద కిడ్స్ ఫేస్ పెయింటింగ్ నాట్ ఫేస్ పెయింటింగ్ హ్యాండ్ పెయింట్ చేసారు ఫేస్ పెయింటింగ్ చేసారు హెనా పెట్టుండారు బ్యూటిఫుల్ డిజైన్స్ వాట్ ఎల్స్ డిడ్ యూ డూ సాధన ఓకే సాధన గాట్ అ బలూన్ యానిమల్ సో చిన్న బిడ్డలు ఉంటే You too, very nice. Please bite upon it, make use of it. There are a lot of volunteers. Biddalni help chestaru.
Popsicle undai. Ee heat ki super ga undi. So popsicle kuda undi. Teesthinochu.
Good job, Harshini. Thank you very much, Kutima. Kana Youth Group Dance. Participants, Anand Ram Mohan, Darini, Joshika, and Praveen Ram Mohan. Please welcome them all.
Yeah. And Veelan Patti Manan Sappalaka. Andru oge urla redu, oge state la kuda redu, different state la undaru. Still, వాళ్ళు
in like Google Hangout, Skype, or FaceTime. Like, dala connect avi, they practice. And just ida vachi, oka 2 days la andru seri undi practice chesinaru. That's a great, great effort. Thank you. And yeah, let's welcome them.
And we have a special request. Meerandaru biddalu kuda, you can start dancing along with them, follow their steps. I know some kutis here, Sachin, Shreeja. Andaru feel free to stand up and dance with the kids, okay?
Yeah.
Let's welcome.
You can come in the front of the stage down and you can dance. Okay?
Let's welcome the Kana Youth Group.
Avunnal nikkura avakannal sokkura naathanal sikkura pinnal sutthura unnal saavura avunnal nikkura andukannal sokkura naathanal sikkura pinnal sutthura unnal saavura oorla avlo ponungirundom luck da unakku adichiruke ada unnal sikkura unnal tikkura unnal vikkura anushka sharma ku koliya pol unakku da nano kedachirken ada unna nadabura unnal saapura
enakku ippo kalyana vayasu da vandu chitti wait pannava illa wait pannava ava unnal nikkura ava kannal sokkura nadanal sikkura unna nadabura unnal saapura
andha ponne neenga da
అమెరికా గర్ల్ అయినా అత్తలి గర్ల్ అయినా యూరప్ గర్ల్ అయినా యానం గర్ల్ అయినా చైనా కెన్యా జార్జియా లిబియా ఆస్ట్రేలియా పాకిస్తాన్ హిందుస్థాన్ ఉజ్బెకిస్తాన్ ఏ గర్ల్ అయినా
Thank you. tell me, I'll take you shopping to the Nalli. I boga dadi talli talli theriyada mamangilli. Party Tamil selfie, I'll take you shopping to the Nalli. I boga dadi talli talli theriyada.
This place is heavy.
டபுள் சைடா லவ் பண்ணதா ரொம்ப நாளா ரெடி. ஹாஃப் ரேட்ல வண்டி வாங்கி உனக்கு ஒரு சுத்தி காட்டட்டுமா? உள்ளாகாத தியேட்டர்ல
Take a breath of air. We would all like to know where you are from and your names also, please.
I'm Praveen. I'm from New York.
Thank you, Praveen.
I'm Joshika. I'm from Frisco.
Thanks, Joshika.
I'm Anand. I'm from Minnesota.
Thank you, Anand.
I'm Dharani. I'm also from Frisco.
Thank you, Dharani.
Thank you, thank you. And
Mirandra, Mirandra,
you know, country la full US cover chesinatta undadi. You all, I don't know how you did it. Was there a 3D way of dancing and practicing? That was amazing. Amazing. Thank you.
Yeah. And mimmalni attane odise kudadu kada meeku super award vera iyala. So we welcome Bhaskar Anna. Please hand over the award to them. It's a small appreciation.
Okay, okay, second seppa idu rendu na allindle idu rendu na kootharle. We all people from the Apex Committee of Kana Bidal.
So Bhaskar Anna, you have some moves. Meero rendu move eyenda.
Dance practice cheyaleduma youngster la chesina ippudu naanda vachi oldest member in this steering committee. So dani ni gurtu pettukali
anna. Ramohan anna, Ramohan anna konja stage ki randa anna.
Cheriche
Praveen, thank you. Joshika, thank you. Anand, thank you. And Darini, thank you.
Kida oga question adavuyene nendu evarnaane birthday date undaya? Anybody has a birthday today? Can you stand up? Anybody has a birthday to stand up today? We want to wish you all a happy birthday. We are bringing our daughter Darini. She has a happy birthday today. Can you all wish her a happy birthday? Thank you. Thank you.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Darini. Happy birthday to you.
Super.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, I heard a once more. Absolutely. Tonight, dance floor, these guys are going to be dancing and we are all going to copy their moves, okay? So be ready.
And next to Chi, oga fusion dance by Lakshanya Thamarai Kannan and choreographed by Lakshanya Thamarai Kannan. So Dani, enjoy Sayenda.
Muredana Mukunda. Saridana Sananda Muripala Mukunda. Saridana Sananda Muridana Mukunda. Saridana Sananda Puvayar Meedu Kanneevada Muraya. Yeda yeda lona nattinchindi chalura. Podumi nee konjam thuyil kollada.
Sumar
karenge sabka swagat. Y'all ready to bring the riff back? Swag se karenge sabka swagat. Swag se karenge sabka swagat.
Super Kanna, super super, very nice,
beautiful dancing. Lakshanya, can you please come back onto the stage?
Lakshanya Kanna, can you please come?
Yeah, thank you.
So Lakshanya orinta mana New Jersey Kana steering committee Tamarai Kannan annanoda kootru. So give a big and ఈ అవార్డు ఇచ్చేదానికి అన్న రాజేష్ సుబ్బయ్య అన్నను పిలిసాము. సో ప్లీజ్
థ్యాంక్ యూ లక్షణ్య. ఆఫ్టర్ దట్ బ్యూటిఫుల్ డ్యాన్స్ ఫ్యూజన్ డ్యాన్స్ వీఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు ద తమిళ్ మెడ్లీ బై గీత అండ్ నిషిత. గీత, నిషిత.
இல்லாமல் வேறில்லையே, உன்னை காணாது நான் இன்று நான் இல்லையே, விதையில்லாமல் வேறில்லையே. கிருஷ்ணா, உன்னை காணாது நான் இன்று நான் இல்லையே, விதையில்லாமல் வேறில்லையே. நிதம் காண்கின்ற வான் கூட நிஜமல்ல, இதம் சேர்க்கும் கணா கூட சுகமல்ல, நீ இல்லாமல் நான் இல்லையே. உன்னை காணாமல், உன்னை காணாமல், உன்னை காணாமல், உன்னை காணாமல், கமதனிதானிதவமகமருகரித, உன்னை காணாமல் பெண் நெஞ்சு தடுமாறுதே, விதையில்லாமல் வேறில்லை.
நளின மோக ஷாமள ரங்கா நடன பாப சுதிலயங்கா சரி வர தூங்காது வாடும் மனதுனம் உனக்காக எங்கும் ராதாதான், உனக்கு என்ன ராதாதான், உனக்கு ஒரு ராதாதான்.
ஒரு மேடையில் இருவருமே கணக்காங்கிறேன், கணக்காங்கிறேன் கண்ணா.
என்று அதையண்ணி வீணேக்கம் ஏங்காமலே உன்னை மூச்சாக்கி வாழ்வேன்.
Good job, Kutis. Very graceful. Thank you so much. It was a treat to our eyes, Kanna. Beautiful, beautiful. Thank you again. ఈ కుటీస్ అవార్డు ఇచ్చేదానికి విని
సూపర్ తెల్లాతన ఉండి ఓడి ఓడి ఒలచి హ్యాండ్సమ్ హీరో ఉండారు ఆ హీరో ఉందా పిలిచి కుటీస్ గిఫ్ట్ చేసప్ప సారీ అవార్డు చేసప్ప
థ్యాంక్ యూ గీత థ్యాంక్ యూ నిషిత నెక్స్ట్ ఇంకా కొద్ది బిడ్ పెద్ద బిడ్డలు డ్యాన్స్ చూడొచ్చిన ఫ్యూజన్ డ్యాన్స్ కొరియోగ్రాఫ్డ్ బై జోషిక సహానా దారిణి అండ్ దీక్ష వెల్కమ్ దెమ్ ఆల్ టు ది స్టేజ్
दीवार प्रेमनिया मौसम छे
अब आओ मेरे पास रह जाओ मेरे साथ बेमनिया मौसम छे
was amazing, amazing performance. Another round of applause to these beautiful young girls.
Oh, super, Kanna. Please introduce yourself.
I'm Joshika, and I'm from Frisco.
I'm Sahana, I'm from Coppell.
I'm Deeksha. I'm from Plano.
I'm Dharani. I'm from Frisco.
And they are from middle schoolers, high schoolers, and college students. So among their, you know, heavy workload, while under seri practices undaru, we need another round of applause for them, please. Thank you.
So we like award iche daniki Sylvia kan pilsene aka please. Joshika.
Sahana, thank you. Deeksha, thank you. And Dharani Kuti, thank you very much. Thank you again.
Thank you, Akka. Thank you.
Jinki Kamal by Geeta Rajkumar, Kanchana Ram Prakash, Kanchana Tamare Kannan, Kavita Rajagopal, and Krishna Veni Vivek Ram. This has been choreographed by Kavita Rajagopal. Take the stage. Akka, thank you, Akka. Please, Akka is going to give a few moves here. Kanchana, thank you. Thank you, Kanchana. Geeta, thank you. Kavita, thank you for also choreographing this beautiful dance. Priyaka, thank you. Priya came all the way from India. So, thank you. And Veni, thank you, my lovely co-host. Now I know why you were wearing the Malayali saree. Nen vere edo onam poi podsochin talustinda பியூட்டிஃபுல் குண்ட. ஸோ ஸோ வெனி, வாட் டு யூ ஃபீல் ஆஃப்டர் தட் யூ நோ ஆல் தட் ஹார்ட் ஒர்க்? இட் வாஸ் பியூட்டிஃபுல். அந்த நிண்டா என்ஜாய் சேஸ்ரி. யா,
தேங்க்யூ தேங்க்யூ. லைக் மா கொஞ்சம் நர்வஸ்காக தான் உண்டா, லைக் ஃபஸ்ட் டைம் இல்லை ஸ்டேஜ் பெர்ஃபார்மன்ஸ் தானே. ஸோ வி ரியலி என்ஜாய்ட் இட். தேங்க்யூ ஃபார் யுவர் சப்போர்ட். ஓகே, ஸோ இப்படி மனக்கு கண்ணுக்கு விருந்து கிடச்சா அண்ட் யோகா நேர்த்திமி ஹெல்த் பற்றி மாற்றாட்டிமி. ஸோ அக்கா,
வாட் இஸ் கம்மிங் நெக்ஸ்ட்?
ஐ திங்க் லாஃபிங் இஸ் ஆல்சோ யோகா, ரைட்?
லாஃபிங் இஸ் யோகா. நிஜங்களேனா?
யா, இட்ஸ் அ பிக் ஸ்ட்ரெஸ் ரிலீவர்.
ஐ அக்ரி கண்ணா, ஐ அக்ரி. பாகா நவ்வி மன ஸ்ட்ரெஸ் அன்னி பர்ஸ் சேசே தானிக்கோசரம் வி ஹாவ் அ ஸ்பெஷல் பர்சனாலிட்டி. வாழ் யாடுண்டு வச்சுண்டார் வேணி?
ஏதோ ஏபிசிடின்னு பேருக்கா? ஏபிசிடின்ட்ட ஏந்தி?
ஓ, அமெரிக்கன் பார்ன் கன்ஃபியூஸ் தேசி.
Confused Desi? Is he really confused? I don't know.
தெலவலேது கண்ணா, அந்தரு சூசி வால் செப்பேதன்னி வினி. I think we'll find out if he's really confused or not.
Yeah, and I know பத்தி நான் கொஞ்சம் நின்றம் வினிந்தா, லைக் கோலிவுட், டோலிவுட், மாலிவுட், பாலிவுட், ரிச்வுட்ஸ், ரிச்வுட்ஸ் அண்ணா.
அவுக்கண்ணா, ரைட் இன் அவர் பேக் யார்ட். அத்தன் தான் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் டைம் மனக்கு அந்தரிக்கு ஜோக்ஸ் செப்பி லேப் செய்ய பெற்றி.
யா,
இப்படி யாடக்கு போயிருன்னு தெரிசுனா?
யாடக்கா?
ஹாலிவுட் வரைக்கும் போயிருந்தாரு.
வா வா வா. ஸோ மனக்கான மன்சி ஹாலிவுட்ல பாப்புலர் ஆக போயிரா? வா, சூப்பர் சூப்பர் சூப்பர். அண்ட் இப்படிதான் வச்சு ஆயின அவைலபிள் விட்டுரு. ஸோ ஒருக்காவது ஆட்டோகிராஃப் தியால்கிட்ட வாங்கி வச்சுக்கோங்கப்பா, அதுக்கப்புறம்லாம் பிடிக்க முடியாது. இது ஒரு நல்ல ஆப்பர்ச்சுனிட்டி, யூஸ் பண்ணிக்கோங்க.
கண்டிப்பாக கண்ணா, கண்டிப்பாக.
பேரண்ட்ஸ், ஸோ
பிரசாந்த் வல் பேரண்ட்ஸ், கேன் யூ ப்ளீஸ் ஸ்டாண்ட் அப் ஸோ வி கேன் ஆல் கிவ் யூ அ ரவுண்ட் ஆஃப் அப்ளாஸ்.
ப்ளீஸ் கம் டு த ஸ்டேஜ். இந்த சூப்பர்கா மன ట్రెడిషన్ అత్తను చెప్పించి మన కానాదాలు వాళ్ళ నిప్పుల్స్ని వచ్చి ఇంత దూరం చేసిన దానికి లైక్ యూ మీకు
దా
చెప్పని వార్త రాలపిని. సో ప్లీజ్,
బోర్డ్ ఆఫ్ డైరెక్టర్ పెరి వెంకట్ వాళ్ళ కొడుకు, లెట్స్ వెల్కమ్
అక్క. యూనో, పెరి వెంకట్ అంకుల్ వచ్చి మా మామతోడ క్లాస్మేట్.
It's a small world. Uncle, please run da.
Usha, please.
Usha, kao.
Huh? Uchara. Oh, okay.
So, Uncle, mana andre enjoy sayyachna?
Super, yeah, definitely.
Uncle.
Sepanda.
Maag autograph kawalta. Mimal contact panta. Kanya autograph tisitra.
I don't know whether he is that big or not. Let's see. He has been doing comedy since almost from 16-17 years. I'm sorry, when he was 16 year old he started doing Comedy Central. I think the first very modati idi evi chethir entante 2004 la we had the tsunami, you remember? So ఆ సునామీ వచ్చిండేప్పుడు ప్రశాంత్ మిసన్ అండ్ ఉషా, ప్రశాంత్ మిసన్ అండ్ హిస్ స్కూల్ మేట్స్, దే కండక్టెడ్ అ ఫండ్ రేసింగ్ థింగ్ అండ్ దాట్ హీ స్టార్టెడ్ ఫస్ట్ స్టాండప్ కామెడీ. దే రేస్డ్ ఆల్మోస్ట్ క్లోజ్ టు $25,000 2004 సునామీ రిలీఫ్ ఫండ్ కోసం రేస్ పండి ఇది పండితే. దెన్ ఆఫ్టర్ దాట్ హీ వాజ్ సో మచ్ ఇంట్రెస్టెడ్ ఆన్ దాట్ అండ్ హీ ప్రాక్టీస్ లాట్. He goes to a lot of colleges and universities to conduct. He has done, I think, close to more than 1,500 or something comedy in the colleges and universities. And now he is more interested in writing and production. Writing and production. And he did Bill Nye show, he did the write-up. Writer, he was one of the writing member for the team. And they got nominated for Emmy for the for that type of writing. There's a different type of writings. He got the nomination for that. And now he's working on a production for Netflix. And that show is called Patriot Act. And he is the co-producer and writer. And he is working with Hasan Minhas. If any of you, many of you know about Hasan Minhas, he was one of the comedian with John Stewart and then Trevor Noah in the Comedy Central. With him, now he is doing a show, Patriot Act. And this is coming in October 28th or something, okay? He is the writer and the co-producer. And when we were talking about Kana and the event and everything, last year, September, we decided to have the event. And I told him more than a year ago that you must come. They were asking. Okay. So he is here now to do that. Thank you.
Thank you, Uncle. Thank you very much. That was an awesome introduction. So without further ado, I think we should call our ABCD.
Yeah. Let's Prashant, welcome Prashant.
Come to the stage.
Thank you guys so much. I guess give a round of applause to my dad for for introducing me. That was very kind of him. Am I projected on these screens? Wow, this is fancy. I'm sorry if people in the back probably can't hear me over the children playing with swords. So I know people want me to do a comedy performance. However, I have been very swamped with the TV show. So I kind of wanted to come today to kind of just talk about what it's been like being an Indian in entertainment and what the journey has been, because my dad, like my dad said, I've been doing comedy for, almost 13, 14 years now, which is pretty crazy to think about. Sure, you can applaud for that. Sure. my dad did ask me about a year ago for me to perform and just come talk at this conference over WhatsApp. And first, just as a general PSA, Indian people need to chill out about WhatsApp. It is too crazy. There's too many threads. You guys post more than teenage girls. It's crazy. Like, there's chain mail. Did you guys see? You're spreading fake news on WhatsApp now. Like, someone got beaten to death because of chain mail sent by aunties and uncles on WhatsApp. It's getting out of control. You need to chill out on WhatsApp. Just as a general PSA. The other PSA, I hope all of you are voting for Beto O'Rourke. I hope there are no Ted Cruz supporters here. That's okay if you are. So my comedy basically started off, it's always been political. And I can tell you why it's always been political, and that is mainly because of my dad. He always had late night on in the house. And it's something that I recommend for, you know, other parents of young children here, because it's when you always kind of have that dialogue in the background. He would just come home every day with just like this head full of steam about what the Republicans were doing. And he's always listening to like progressive talk radio. So that was like a big influence on me. And it started kind of just like, oh, it was like, oh, you're allowed to talk about this stuff at home and you're allowed to think about this stuff. And this was like a very pivotal moment in my life. My parents took me and my sister to Las Vegas when I was about 13 years old. And they wanted to go gamble, which I don't know if I'm allowed to say, but they did. They wanted to go gamble. And they couldn't take me or Preeti with them because obviously they don't allow, you know, people under a certain age to come with. So they were like, my sister was just like, let's go see a show. And, but you know, up until this point, we had been seeing like magicians and Vegas dancers and stuff like that. Like it had just been like very like family oriented programming. And then my sister was like, oh, we should go see George Carlin. There's a whole faction of people from this road that just went, oh, no. Round of applause. Do people know who George Carlin is by round of applause? Okay, so a lot of you don't. He's basically one of these comedians that came up in the 60s and the 70s. He's very, very political. He's the best. He is awesome. But he's definitely not for children. Like, when I say definitely not for children, he is, there's no reason a 13-year-old should have gone to see that show. But my dad just let us go. Which was a great, that he deserves a round of applause for that. He was just like, yeah, I'll buy you guys tickets. And he just let us go. And I don't even know how I got in, to be honest, because it was me. I was like 13 years old, and it was just the sea of adults listening to this pretty filthy comedian. But it was the first time where, that's the one thing, by the way, that I love about performing for like these, like Thummelchungam things, is they'll just fix the set while you're doing your thing. People from the audience will just be like, Mike, Mike, and then someone will come and tip your hand. Like they, we can see you. Everyone can see you fixing the set. Anyway, so like my dad let us go to this performance, and it was honestly, like without question, one of the most mind-blowing changes in my life, because I realized that comedy could have been a career path. And I know there are a lot of parents here that just don't think entertainment is a real thing. It's like a very weird industry, and it doesn't make sense from the outside, so people are obviously very afraid of it. But it was the first time that it kind of cemented, like, oh, we can do this. We can, you know, be in films, and we can act, and we can do this kind of stuff. But like in 2004, 2005, I wasn't, like, there were not many Indian people in the public eye, you know? Like, the first time I saw an Indian person on screen in America was Cal Penn from Harold and Kumar, right? And at that time, he was just the first. He was like the first person that had sort of broken through. And it kind of felt like, oh, I missed the boat, and I didn't, you know, I missed it. And now there's going to be a lot of Indians and Asians. But only now are we seeing a lot of Indian people and Asian people. You have like Aziz Ansari, Mindy Kaling, Crazy Rich Asians, Ronnie Chang, like all these comedians that are coming up. And it's really a phenomenal time to be a person of color and someone of Indian descent in Hollywood. Like, I'm not kidding you. There's so many people that want to take meetings with Indian people now. It's so bizarre. It makes no sense. It's crazy. And it's like a very like rich time. And one of the things about that I kind of learned, and so around this time when I was in college is kind of when I met Hassan and we started doing shows together. This is Hassan Minhaj. My dad, you know, I'll just say it a little bit more clearly. So we have a show coming out on Netflix on October 28th. I hope you guys all watch. It's going to be a political late night show. He's the first Indian American late night show talk show host, and we are the first weirdly Indian co-creators. And it's around that time is when I met him, and we started writing together and working together. And one thing that kind of happened with both of our careers is we both kind of pivoted from doing straight stand-up to something a little bit different, and kind of all these other doors started opening. You know, he doesn't do straight stand-up. He does like a hybrid of like storytelling, and he talks about his family. And have people seen Homecoming King here? By a round of applause? Okay, so like everybody under the age of 25. So when we started, we pivoted because when you're auditioning, it's like really, like auditioning in Hollywood is a very weird thing because you basically go sit in a room and then there's like 15 other Indian guys that look just like you that are there. And here's the weird thing to me is that they're casting for like the nerdiest Indian person ever. Like they want the nerdiest Indian guy. And that's always been a fascinating dichotomy for me as an Indian man in this country, because every role you see an Indian person in this country is kind of dorky IT person. But then you look at like South Indian films and Bollywood, and Indian dudes just look like WCW wrestlers. Like, they're oiled up, they're jacked, they're clearly all taking steroids. It's bizarre. And like, that dichotomy and like that bridge is sort of starting to happen, where you see Asian men starting to finally be in like serious roles here. So one of the reasons why we pivoted was because if you always are begging in Hollywood, you will never get the opportunities you want. If you're always on the side of like, oh, casting director or person, give me money to make my film, it's very difficult. You know, there's this thing I tell people when they ask me about what it's like to work in Hollywood, is that if you're Indian or Asian, you can become quickly a C or B list actor because you're always a side character. But it's very difficult to become an A-list or A-list talent or an A-list producer, because all those roles are written for white dudes and white women, right? Like, you can't break through. You can, if your name is everywhere as a C-list actor, the next opportunity isn't there. The rung on the ladder literally does not exist. And so one of the reasons why Hassan and I started working together and producing together is because the only way Indians will start becoming more prominent in entertainment is if we actually form the production companies and we own the means of production, and then we reach out to other talent and we go, hey, I like your pilot, I like your screenplay, come work with us. And that's why like Hassan and I started working together, and we're, you know, thinking about starting a production company for that reason. And it's one of the reasons I've started a company. See, that's exactly what I'm saying. Like, in the middle of everything, they'll just be like, we need light in that area of the room, so... Or they're just turning it up for reasons that are more practical. Wow, there's a lot of people in here. What's that? What, you want me to know a lot of people here? Okay, good, yeah, let's bail on this. So we started working together, and we... You know, we were basically like, let's start getting Indian people more. And I think one of the other things I wanted to talk about is, you guys, you know my dad, and you know my mom, and trying to go into entertainment when you're a child of Indian descent in our culture is very difficult. People are very resistant to it because they don't understand it. And I totally get that concern, because it's a very unknown field. It's not like, oh, I go to Berkeley or I go to the University of Illinois, I get a computer science degree, and I'm set. There's a lot of false starts. And just to tell you about my career, like, when I started doing open mics, and I started just, you know, that's all you're doing. You're just going to bars and you're telling jokes to strangers and you're trying to get good, because you actually are trying to get good at, like, a craft, and you're trying to, you know, make a name for yourself. But it doesn't happen right away. Like, it's a very difficult thing. Meaning, like, I had day jobs, like, I worked. So, like, there's a little bit of both the parents and the kids that I both understand, because if I were a parent, I would be like, yeah, you shouldn't go in entertainment unless you prove to me that you're willing to do whatever it takes to become successful. Right, because it takes so much more effort to try and become an entertainer. Like, it just, you have to work basically two jobs. So for many, many years, I had a day job from 9 to 5, and then from 5 to midnight, I would be writing, or I'd be, you know, going to open mics, and I'd be doing stand-up to get good. And it's like, it is, there is this practicality to it. So like, parents, in a sense, need to be more open to these careers, but also, like, if you're a kid that wants to go into it, it's very difficult if you're not thinking about your dreams in a practical way. Because at the end of the day, like, they, like, tangible things need to happen if you actually want to, you know, succeed and, like, you know, work in entertainment. Like, one of the things that was, like, crazy is, like, Hassan was asked to do the White House Correspondents' Dinner in 2017. I don't know if you guys saw that performance. and I was the head writer for it. And it was a very, very bizarre gig. And I'll tell you a little bit about it because not many people know how a dinner like that comes together. He had found out about the gig like 3 weeks before we were supposed to perform, and Donald Trump had already decided he wasn't going to come. Which was like, it's a very weird thing because the tradition of the White House Correspondents' Dinner is that the president shows up and you get to roast him and make fun of him, and he just obviously decided not to come. And we had to write the dinner in 3 weeks. And it almost killed us. So like the practicality of it is that I basically went to New York and I slept on his couch, and for 3 weeks we just wrote this speech with other writers. And he rehearsed it every single night at the Comedy Cellar. He probably performed it 60 to 70 times before we actually did the actual dinner. Like, we both would go down there and he would rehearse all 25 minutes of it. And then when we put it up, and it was a very, like, it's that level of insanity kind of needs to happen, because these things just don't, it, from the outside, they look very polished and they look like they just happen, but it's, production is called production because it is like this insane thing. I'm trying to think what else I wanted to talk about tonight, because I honestly, at some point, you know, I don't want to talk too much, because I think that, you know, in the last couple of years, we've gotten to see what and how entertainment works from the ground level. Like, we're starting the show, we had to hire all these writers. You know, we're literally building a team of like 60 people that are gonna make this one Netflix show of like 1,000. And so I kind of wanted to open it up if people had questions for me or wanted to ask me anything about like stand up from a parental standpoint or from like any kids that are interested in getting into entertainment. I'm more than happy to be a resource, but if there's any questions that you guys are interested in asking me, I'm more than happy to answer them if people are curious. None? That's fine. Oh, the mic is coming. Okay.
Who is that?
Oh, yeah. The mic? Oh, I see. Who? Okay, so someone sent me this question. I guess, who is your favorite Indian comedian? Which is a very loaded question, because if I don't say Hassan, then something seems wrong. Yeah. Or I guess just Russell Peters. Russell Peters fans, okay. Here's the honest truth, and I will tell you guys this. If you have the chance to go see live comedy, the best comedians are not always the famous ones. The best ones are the ones out on the road who are practicing and rehearsing, and they're not, like, TV famous. But yeah, I will say... Oh, sorry, yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, it's too loud. How did your parents, your mom or dad, let you slip away from the traditional doctor and engineer stuff?
How did I veer off the path?
Yes.
This is going to be a more existential answer than probably is right for this forum. No, they were very resistant, like, at first, because they're scared. They're just scared that you're going to be, like, homeless by the time you're 35 with no degree. I like that got a round of applause. They're like, yeah, that is a very, yes, that is real. I could see my life from even 16, because I'll be honest, like, I was good at school, but I really didn't like going to school, which is not a good thing you should say in front of Indian people. I get that. But I learn, like, I think Indian kids in general, like, I'll just say this openly, like, I have this problem with my cousins in India. They're so pampered. They're so insulated from the real world. They have no ability to just do life stuff. And so, like, I learned best, like, one of the things I'll, you know, give props to my dad for is, like, he just made me work in warehouses for the first, like, from the age of, like, 15, he'd be like, yeah, go, you have to go deliver this package to this random place, and I'd be like, I don't know how to get there. And he would kind of just be like, figure it out. And I would just have to go do these manual tasks. Like, I worked in warehouses, you know, packaging towels for a lot of my life. And I think, like, I learn best doing something. Like, it's hard for me to be lectured to. I have to, like, fail and get good at something like that. And I think more Indian kids, and I think parents should be open to their kids doing that kind of stuff. Like, let your kid get a job as a server or work in a manual labor job. They need, in my opinion, I feel like they need to know what it's like to be one of those people, because we're so in the expectation of kids making 200 grand after med school or finance or whatever. But like, if they're so disconnected from people who actually do the manual labor of the world, like, they're just gonna grow up to be assholes. Like, that's just the truth. Like, that's the problem. They need to be grounded to the world. You know what I mean? Like, that's just that's the reality of it.
Okay, so I love comedy. I kind of watch pretty much.
Mike.
I kind of watch pretty much all the comedians, okay? So
yeah.
What I think is, but 99% of the comedians, they don't be successful unless they use a lot of profanity.
Yeah.
Okay, there are very few exceptions. Seinfeld doesn't do it.
Yeah.
Okay, he's the most successful, if not. So how are you going to break through that?
The profanity? I kind of just did.
do you do that?
No. Here's the thing. I don't believe, and this is an interesting thing that Hassan and I talk about all the time, because he is not a dirty comedian. He does not use foul language like that often to make his jokes. You do not at all need to be dirty or profane to make a good point, right? The only thing, though, is you can't shy away from subject matter that is the real world, right? Like, this is another thing that I think there's going to be. So Homecoming King, I think, set the stage for the immigrant experience as a first-generation kid. And I think first-generation stories are being told with Fresh Off the Boat, Mindy, Aziz, like, all these people are talking about what it's like to be a first generation, right? And it's very standard issues of my parents don't understand me, and we, our community is very insulated and all these things. But there's going to be another wave of Indian American stories or Indian stories that actually deal with the realities of just what all Indian people go through, which is like, there are stories of people, you know, in Indian communities that struggle with domestic abuse, alcoholism, these things that are considered taboo, but that the community needs to talk about more, otherwise they never get actually dealt with. And I think there's going to be a crop of stories and comedians that actually talk about that and kind of humanize the immigrant experience in a way that I think is going to be good for everybody. So, like, if you have a strong point to make, you absolutely do not need to curse. You can say, like, something very powerful, but it doesn't need to be rooted in profanity. In fact, like, when I see new comedians, if I see them swearing a lot up top, it's very easy to go, they're not ready, because they're leaning on the F word, they're leaning on all these words to get the laugh or the punchline. It shows they're not actually thinking about the meaning behind the joke that they're trying to tell. So by no means is profanity, like, necessary. Yeah. Are there any other questions? Go ahead.
Hey, sorry. So, yeah, like, there's a lot of hard work you put into it to get up to here, right?
There's a lot of what?
A lot of hard work that you had to put in, a lot of risks taken. Can you tell us about one really big make or break moment that brought you into the industry and kind of gave you the next rung on that ladder?
Yeah. This is all, like, this is the case with everybody in entertainment, is, like, you only find out about what they do at, like, the tail end of the stuff that you recognize. But honestly, one of the things that I did was I would make my own short films with my friends. And the thing to keep in mind is, like, all these things are, like, incremental things that add to your portfolio, right? So when I got hired on Bill Nye, I had been doing comedy for like 10 years already, and I just had this body of work. And this is the truth, like, at the end of the day, someone does need to take a chance on you to be like, yeah, this kid deserves a shot. But if you go into entertainment, I promise you, you will get that shot. It really is a very small community. Someone from CBS, NBC, ABC, Netflix, Fox, wherever, your packet, your material, it will show up on their desk. It's just a matter of, like, were you ready when they finally got it? Is it good enough? Like, it will get read. People cold email me through my website all the time to work on Patriot Act. They're like, I know this is a shot in the dark, but hey, like, will you read this? And I'll email them back and I go, yeah, I'll give it a look, but I don't know if it's ready. But they use their shot with me to be like, can you read my stuff? But then I can't go back to them because there's a bunch of other people that are looking for jobs. You know what I mean? So it's like, it's really like that make or break moment. Like Bill Nye was that for me to a degree, but it honestly happened before because one of the other jobs I was up for was Jon Stewart's HBO project, like right around that time. And I almost got hired for that, but I'm kind of glad I didn't because it ended up not going to air. And Netflix ended up going with Bill Nye. And I ended up actually, there's another talk show coming out on Netflix called The Fix, which I also sold this year. It's been a very weird year. So there are two talk shows coming out in the fall that I helped produce. And it was because I ended up getting in with Netflix when they were getting into the talk space right now. One more. Two? Yeah, sure.
So, hello. So congratulations on your success in this career. You sound
Thanks.
Certainly precociously wise. So I'm very proud of a lot of balance you have. I have a very simple question. So as an immigrant who lives in this town, I see color more blatantly than my children. My children seem to be more blind about who they are. Do I make sense?
Yeah.
Like they basically think they are American and they're part of. My question to you is, having the color, the name, and who you are, does it help you or hurt you in your path?
Yeah, that's a
very
awesome
very simple question, though.
Yeah, so when I started doing stand-up, I was very borderline arrogant about not wanting to change my name because everybody is like, change your name. You have to make it shorter, more easy to say, and all this stuff. And I just didn't want to because I was like, look, people learned how to say Schwarzenegger. Like, Venkataramanajam isn't that much crazier. And so I made a very conscious choice to keep it because I was kind of like, yeah, I don't want to turn into Bobby Jindal. You know what I mean? I didn't want to, like, go and then be like, hey, I'm Dave, nice to meet you, like, into a casting director, and they're like, you're clearly not Dave. I do that for Starbucks, though. That is my Starbucks name, because that's just a hassle. But I think, especially now, no one has to change their name or identity. In fact, people are buying stories, and they're interested in stories the more specific they are. So, like, you do not have to whitewash or water down your heritage to be in this industry anymore. It's just, it does not need to be that way. In fact, the more you lean into it, the better it is.
First, I have a question and then I have a request. First,
sure.
Do you know how to speak Tamil and Telugu? Or understand
okay.
it at first?
Here's the thing. I went to Tamil class. Okay? But my parents never, like, enforced a policy at home to speak a Tamil, so I never, like, learned how to speak it well. Okay, here's a perfect example, right? They spoke a hybrid of English, Telugu, and Tamil. And if you're a kid and you have no idea, like, what the mishmash of Telugu or Tamil is, you're like, I don't know what these words are and which is part of which language. Like, punda in one language means fruit or banana. Another, a punda means sleep in another one. So it's like, if you're like, what do you want me to do with that? Like, sleep banana? They never were like, yeah, this is punda in this language. And so it's just like, I understand it. I can't speak it. I understand this weird hybrid language to an extent. But unfortunately, like, I'm not as proficient as I would like.
Can I have your autograph?
No, you don't want my autograph. But yeah, if you really want, yeah, for sure. But of course, but do you want jokes? I don't know. I don't know, like, most of my jokes are not appropriate for this crowd. Five people are just like, be funny. By the way, this kid right here is living his best life. Amazing. Just fedora and Oakley sunglasses, and he's just been hopping around the convention. No shame. It's amazing. It's amazing.
Okay. My question, I have two questions.
Yeah.
My first one is, do you ever perform with Hasan Minhaj?
You know what? He's going on tour right now to promote the show. And I unfortunately have to kind of hold down the fort at the office because we're under like a pretty tight deadline. But if like I wanted to open for him in Chicago because he's doing the Chicago theater. And if any of you guys, you know, if you look on his tour schedule and you see tickets that you guys want to get, like, and you want to go see him perform, like, you can definitely ask me. I can get you in for free and you guys can go see some of the material we're working on for Patriot Act. None of the uncles. I'm talking to the kids. Uncles, the kids, this is for the kids. But the goatee makes you look like an uncle, so unfortunately. Maybe a few aunties. But yeah, I sometimes will open for him if, you know, if I have the time. But my job right now is to kind of keep the show running.
Okay. My second question is, do you think you're ever going to get your own Netflix show?
If I am?
Yeah.
Maybe. I don't know. If this one's a hit, then I'll let you know if I can sell another one. But maybe. We'll see. Yes, I've been waiting to hear from you all night. Yes. What is your name?
Rithik.
What's up? One more time?
Rithik.
Rithik.
Yeah.
Dude, I'm loving it. The watch. Who bought you that fedora?
Oh, wait, this?
Yeah.
Oh, I just bought it from a store. Myself.
You just, and this is like this is the look at school and like.
No, I bought it like.
Oh, this is just the weekend look.
Yeah.
Okay.
Wait, my question was, what was your favorite like act or comedian area so far?
What was my favorite?
Like, performance.
Oh, two, actually, that's a great question. Two, one of them is a super clean comedian and he's one of the funniest specials I've seen all year. This guy named Ryan Hamilton, he has a special on Netflix. It's a hilarious special, totally good for the kids. And then Nanette, if you guys heard of Nanette, that special was also awesome. Those are two of the best specials, I think, this year. All right, okay. Are we good?
This is the last question. Yeah, I know this boy, Prashant.
Oh, this is from you?
Yeah.
Oh, wow, okay.
I know this boy, Prashant, since the age of four. So your dad, Mr. Peri Venkat, is a board of director for Khanna.
Yeah.
How do you feel about it?
Can I what?
Raise the money for Khanna.
Raise what money for Khanna? Oh, do a fundraiser for Khanna. I can help, but I unfortunately am like drowning in work right now. That it's going to be difficult. But I do want to, like, I think we should give another round of applause to, like, the people that helped set this up, because it's, like, an awesome organization, and I think the mission statement is really great. So. Oh, did I not? How did I feel about it? Was that the question? Oh, it's great. He has something to do. It's fantastic. Like, at this point, Preethi and I have been so busy that if we don't get a chance to call, if we need to find out if the parents are still alive, we just check WhatsApp and see how much they've been posting. And I'm like, okay, good. No one's fallen and broken a hip. They're still just on the WhatsApp. Like, yeah, no, I think it's great. And I think more elderly Indian men need to, like, talk to one another and, like, have conversations and not be so stoic and angry looking all the time. One more? Last one, okay.
Prashant, thanks for answering my question. But your dad's very favorite mantra is, I'm already retired, I'm a retired person.
I'm sorry, I did not hear that. Oh, I guess we'll just move on.
Yes, I want to say only one thing. You are a fundraiser. Your dad is a fundraiser for Kana. That's it.
Oh. See, you don't need profanity to be hilarious. I don't know what's next, but I'm sorry I couldn't prepare a full show for you guys, so I hope this was helpful, interesting. You guys obviously know my dad. If there's any kids that want to reach out and ask questions about any of this stuff, like, this is, like, Indian people are starting to get into entertainment, so, like, consider Hassan, myself, a resource. You can get to us. You can ask us questions. If you want to come to the show, if you want to come to a taping, if you want to see how a Hollywood show is made, you are more than welcome. Please encourage your kids to pursue the arts. Thank you, guys.
Prashant, hang on. You're not done yet. You're not done yet. So if you don't mind, and if the audience doesn't mind, I would like everybody to give him a standing ovation, please.
This is not how standing ovations work. You have to do it on will. We all know this is a lie now.
And Rajalakshmi Sureshaka, please surrender. Manam Prashant ok award cheyochu. It renda Prashant.
She said, oh, we're giving you this because you did a good job. And I said, would I have not gotten this had I done a bad job?
No, sorry.
Which, that would have been awesome if you withheld it, if I bombed.
This is for, yeah, that's simply for.
No, I appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you, Prashant, for patiently answering all our questions. Thank you, Akka.
Thank you, Akka.
Ippudu Veni, andaru baa navundaru. వచ్చి ఇప్పుడు ఇండియాలో ఉండే వచ్చి కొద్ది గెస్ట్ని పిలవబోయాము. సో ఫస్ట్ ఆన్ అవర్ లిస్ట్ ఇస్ మిస్టర్ కవితాలయ సరవణన్ ఫ్రమ్ తేని. ప్లీజ్ రండా మేడకు వచ్చి షేర్ యువర్ థాట్స్.
మీరు అత్త దూరం నుండి ఇక్కడ వచ్చినారు, సో మాకు నిండా పెరమగా ఉంది మమ్మల్ని అందరినూ మీట్ చేసేందుకు. సో మీన్ నో వర్డ్స్, నిండా హ్యాపీగా ఉంది. ప్లీజ్ స్టేజ్కి రండా.
Let's welcome Kavitalayana with a round of applause, please. Thank you.
Hello. I would like to introduce Mr. Kavitalaya Saravanan. He did a lot of help for Kana from Theni side, and he is the Theni Kamavar Sangam Thalaivar. Thank you.
Anaivarukkum Malai Vanakkam. Inda Brahmandamana Manattai Erpadu Seithu Nadathikondirukkum Vada America Kamavar Sangha Thalaivar Matrum Nirvaagigaludan Tholodu Thol Koduthu Nindra Inda Vilavinai Sirappithukondirukkum Kana Uripinargal Matrum அமெரிக்காவில் பிற மாநிலங்களில் இருந்து வருகை தந்திருக்கும் சகோதர சகோதரிகளே, உலகளவில் பிற நாடுகளிலிருந்து தமிழகத்திலிருந்தும் தன்னிலம் கருதாது பொதுநல நோக்கோடு புறப்பட்டு மண்ணிலிருந்து கிளம்பி விண்ணில் பறக்கும் விமானத்தில் ஏறி அமெரிக்கா வந்தடைந்த என் கம்ம உறவுகள் அத்தனை பேருக்கும் தேனி மாவட்ட கம்மவார் சங்கத்தின் சார்பாக எனது வணக்கத்தையும், தேனி மாவட்ட கம்மவார் சங்க நிர்வாகிகள் மற்றும் உறுப்பினர்கள் சார்பாகவும் எனது வாழ்த்துக்களையும் தெரிவித்துக் கொள்கிறேன். ஒரு சங்கம் அமைப்பது எவ்வளவு சிரமம் என்பது நான் மிகவும் நன்றாக அறிவேன். அதுவும் வெளிநாடுகளில் அமெரிக்காவில் வாழ்வதே உலக மக்கள் ஒரு கனவாக எண்ணும் நினைக்கும் இடத்தில் கால் ஊன்றி உணவுகளை உறவுகளை ஒருங்கிணைத்து இவ்வளவு பிரம்மாண்டமான மாநாட்டை நடத்துவதென்பது மிகப்பெரிய சாதனை. இதற்கு ஒத்துழைப்பு நல்கிய அவர்களின் துணைவியார் மற்றும் குடும்ப உறுப்பினர்கள் அனைவருக்கும் மிகப்பெரிய கைதட்டலுடன் எனது பாராட்டுக்களை தெரிவித்துக் கொள்கிறேன். கானா என்றவுடன் அனைவருக்கும் மனதில் உற்சாகமும் ஆனந்தும், ஏனெனில் கானா பாடல்கள் அவ்வளவு உற்சாகத்தை கொண்டது, தள்ளாடும் கிழவனை கூட எழுந்து நடக்கும் ஆற்றல் கொண்டது போல இந்த அமைப்பு பெயராலேயே உறவு பெற்றது. கம்மவார் என்பது வெறும் குலம் அல்ல, பெயரால நமக்கு மிக பெரிய கௌரவம். ஏனெனில் உலகம் முழுவதும் நமக்கு ஒரு கௌரவத்தையும் தனி இடத்தையும் நம் முன்னோர்கள் நமக்கு ஏற்படுத்திவிட்டு சென்றுன்றார்கள் என்றால் மிகையாது. எங்கிட்டு சென்றாலும் எந்த சூழலிலும் நம் குணமும் நம் பண்பும் மாறுவதில்லை என்பதுதான் நம் சமூகத்துக்கு பெருமை. நாம் யார் என்பதை நம் குழந்தைகளுக்கு முழுமையாக சொல்லிக் கொடுங்கள். உறவுகள் இல்லாதவன் மனிதன் அல்ல. நம் குழந்தைகளை உறவுகளை பார்க்க வாய்ப்பு உள்ளதோ இல்லையோ நம் பெற்றோர்கள் நம் பெரியோர்கள் தாத்தா பாட்டியுடன் எடுத்த நம் ஃபோட்டோக்களை காண்பித்து இது தாத்தா நமது பாட்டி அவர்கள் செய்த சாதனை அவர்கள் நமக்கு சொல்லிக் கொடுத்த நல்ல பண்புகளை அவங்களுக்கு நாம் விளக்க வேண்டும். நல்ல குணங்களையும் அவங்களுக்கு தெரிவிக்க வேண்டும். தொலைபேசியில் பேசும்போது இங்கே அமெரிக்காவிலிருந்து பேசும்போது நிறைய பேர் தாத்தா பாட்டி தெரியாது. இது நம்ம தாத்தா, ஹாய் டாட், ஹாய் அங்கிள்னு சொல்லாமல் இது நம்ம தாத்தா மாமா சித்தப்பா என்று உறவுகளை சொல்லி அவர்களை அழைக்க வேண்டும். இந்தியா கானாபின் மாநாடு உலக முழுவதும் உள்ளவர்களில் கம்மவால் மத்தியில் ஒரு புத்துணர்ச்சியை ஏற்படுத்தியுள்ளது. நம் பொருளாதார வளர்ச்சியில் நாம் மிக பெரிய சாதனை படைத்திருந்தாலும் நாம் செய்யும் ஒரே தவறு நம் பிள்ளைகளை டாக்டர் அல்லது இன்ஜினியர் ஆக்க வேண்டும் என்று அந்த இரண்டை தவிர நாம் எண்ணுவதில்லை. தயவு செய்து நாம் மிகப்பெரிய வெற்றியை காண வேண்டிய ஒரு சூழல் உருவாகியுள்ளது என்றால் நம் பிள்ளைகளை ஐஏஎஸ் ஐபிஎஸ் மற்றும் நிறைய மத்திய அரசாங்கத்தினுடைய நிறைய படிப்புகள் உள்ளன, அதில் நாம் இருந்து நாம் வெற்றி பெற வேண்டும். நம் பிள்ளைகளை எடுத்துக்கொண்டால் அதிகபட்சமாக இன்ஜினியர் டாக்டர் என்றே நாம் போய்கொண்டிருக்கிறோம். அதனால் நாம் அதில் கவனம் செலுத்த வேண்டும். அடுத்தபடியாக கானா நிர்வாகிகளை நான் கேட்டுக்கொள்வதெல்லாம், நிறைய பேர் இங்கிருந்து அங்கு இந்தியாவுக்கு பொன் கிடைக்கவில்லை, அங்கிருப்பவர்கள் இங்கு மாப்பிள்ளை கிடைக்கவில்லை என்றெல்லாம் ஒரு ஐயப்பாடு உள்ளது. ஏனென்றால் அவர்கள் இங்கு அமெரிக்காவில் வாழ்ந்து கொண்டு எப்படி நாம் ஒரு உறவுகளை இன்று பார்த்தேன். நான் ஒரு சில புக்குகளில் நம்மளுடைய குலப்பெயர்கள் எல்லாம் உள்ளது, அதில் ஒன்று ரெண்டு விடுபட்டு உள்ளது, அதையும் சரி செய்ய வேண்டும். நாம் வருங்காலத்தில் நம் கல்வி ஸ்தாபனங்கள் நம் பெரியோர்களால் நிறைய ஸ்தாபனங்கள் நிறுவப்பட்டிருந்தாலும் கூட அதை மெயின்டைன் பண்ண முடியாமல் நிறைய பேர் இருக்காங்க. அதுக்கு இந்த கானா மூலமாக நிறைய உதவிகள் செய்து அங்குள்ள நாம் முன்னோர்கள் ஏற்படுத்திய கல்வி நிறுவனங்களை காப்பாற்ற வேண்டும். அரசியலை எடுத்துக்கொண்டால் நாம் மிகவும் குறைவாக உள்ளோம், கண்டிப்பாக அதில் நாம் வெற்றி பெற வேண்டும். இந்த தடவை தேனி மாவட்டம் கண்டிப்பாக ஒரு கம்மவார் எம்எல்ஏவை உருவாக்கும் என்பதில் நான் உறுதி கூறுகிறேன். காரணம் என்றால் நாங்கள் போகும் இடமெல்லாம் நாம் சொல்வது என்னவென்றால், நாம் குலத்தில் உயர்ந்திருக்கிறோம், பணம் படைத்திருக்கிறோம், எல்லாம் இருக்கிறோம், பட் நாம் ஏன் ஒரு அரசியலையோ எதுலேயோ நாம் முன்ன வரவில்லை என்பதுதான் ஆச்சரியமாக இருக்கிறது. தயவுசெய்து நீங்களும் ஊரில் பேசும்போது அவர் எந்த கட்சியில் நிற்பார் என்பது நமக்கு பெரிதல்ல, பட் நாம் ஓட்டுகளை பிரிக்க வேண்டும், நாம் அதில் வெற்றி பெற வேண்டும், அரசியல் வாழ்க்கை அரசியல்வாதிகளை நம்மளை திரும்பி பார்க்க வேண்டும் என்பது நமது ஆசை. உண்மையிலே இதுபோல் ஒரு மிகப்பெரிய பிரம்மாண்ட மாநாட்டில் கலந்து கொள்ள வாய்ப்பு கொடுத்தமைக்கு நன்றி விடைபெறுகிறேன். நன்றி, வணக்கம்.
தேங்க்யூ அண்ணா, தேங்க்யூ. அண்ட் ஒரு 3 இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் அனௌன்ஸ்மெண்ட்ஸ் உண்டு, ஆக்சுவலி 4 இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் அனௌன்ஸ்மெண்ட்ஸ். அக்கா ஸ்டார்ட்.
ஓகே, டின்னர் இஸ் ஓப்பன். సో మన అందరు తినని పోవచ్చుండ, నీళ్ళు వేస్ట్ చేయదండ, నిండ పేరు ఓసి పెట్టి బాటిల్ ఉడిసిపెట్టారు. యూ కెనాట్ ఫిగర్ అవుట్ విచ్ ఇస్ యువర్ బాటిల్, సో ప్లీజ్ డోంట్ వేస్ట్ ద వాటర్. ఫ్యామిలీస్ విత్ లిటిల్ కిడ్స్ దే హ్యావ్ ద ఫస్ట్ ప్రెఫరెన్స్, మీరు డిన్నర్కి పోవచ్చు. అండ్ ఫోటో బూత్ ఇస్ గోయింగ్ టు బి క్లోజ్డ్ నౌ అంటిల్ డిన్నర్. అందుకే డిన్నర్ కానుకే తిప్పి ఓపెన్ చేసాము, ప్లీజ్ వచ్చి ఫోటోస్ ఎత్తండ. Oh, it's closed for the day. The photo booth is closed for the day, but it'll open up again tomorrow with a brand new background. So Kandeep gar epu tippi photo ettanda.
Infant doll nu kelipotirpinga ellarum, avangaloda owner and the product oda owner avarda Madurai Kammavar Sangha thalaivara irundirukanga. Then kaanavukku neriya help pannitirukanga mama.
எனக்கு வழங்கப்பட்டிருக்கிற நேரம் வந்து 2 நிமிஷம் தான். அது நாங்கள் ஒரு 20 மணி நேரம் பிரயாணம் பண்ணிட்டு இவ்வளவு தூரம் அமெரிக்கா வரணுமா அப்படின்ற ஒரு பெரிய திருப்பி போகும்போது எங்களுக்கு தெரியுது இன்னும் 20 மணி நேரம் ட்ராவல் பண்ணணுமேன்ட்டு. இருந்தாலும் இங்கே வந்து சங்கமித்த நம்ம சொந்தங்கள் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா, இது மதுரையிலேயோ சென்னையிலையோ நாம் நடத்தியிருந்தால் கூட இந்த மாதிரி பழைய ஆளுக்களை சந்திக்க முடியுமாங்கிற ஒரு சந்தேகத்தில் அத்தனை பேர் இருந்திருக்கீங்க. இது நிச்சயமாக முடியாத விஷயம். இது வந்து நாங்கள் நேற்று வந்து டெக்சாஸில் ஒரு கைடு வச்சு போனோம், அவர் சொல்கிறது எதுவும் புரியலை. இருந்தாலும் சுற்றி பார்த்தோம், சரி ஒரு நாள் வம்பாக போச்சுன்னு நினச்சிட்டோம். இப்போ இன்றைக்கு உண்மையிலேயே ரொம்ப யூஸ்ஃபுல்லாக இருந்துச்சு. இந்த கானா அசோசியேஷன் வந்து இங்கே உள்ள நம்ம இனத்து மக்கள் இங்கே பல வகைகளில் வந்து பெரிய வசதி படைத்தவர்களாக இருக்காங்க. இந்த அமெரிக்கா வந்து ஒரு பெர்ஃபெக்டிவ், அதாவது பெர்ஃபெக்ஷனில் எல்லாத்துலேயும் ஒரு பெரிய பெரிய லெவலில், எதையுமே சின்ன லெவலில் எதையுமே செய்கிறது இல்லை, ஒரு பெரிய லெவல் ரொம்ப ரொம்ப பெருசாகவும் செய்கிறாங்க, பெர்ஃபெக்டாகவும் செய்கிறாங்க. அந்த அளவு செய்கிற அளவுக்கு அவங்க பண வளம் இருக்கு, பொருளாதார வளம் இருக்குது. இப்போது நீங்கள் எல்லாம் நம்ம இடத்துலேருந்து வந்திருக்கீங்க, இவங்க எப்படி இந்த பொருளாதார வளத்தை கொண்டு வந்தாங்க, இந்த லெவலில் எப்படி செய்ய முடியுது, இதையே நம்ம இந்தியாவிலேயும் நம்ம ஊர்களிலையும் செய்ய முடியாது. நம்ம மதுரைக்கு தெற்கு புறத்துலேருந்து நீங்கள் எல்லாம் வந்திருக்கீங்க, எல்லாம் சிவகாசி கோவில்பட்டி அந்த பக்கங்கள்லாம் எல்லாம் ராஜபாளையம் இந்த பக்கம் மதுரையிலேருந்து வந்திருக்கீங்க, ஏன் அந்த ஏரியாவை அமெரிக்கா மாதிரி ஏன் ஆக்கக்கூடாது? அது ஆக்கலாம் கண்டிப்பாக, நீங்கள்லாம் நினச்சிங்கன்னா நம்ம தென் தமிழகத்தை ஒரு அமெரிக்காவாக நீங்கள் மாற்ற முடியும். அதுக்கு நீங்கள் எல்லோரும் நினச்சிங்கன்னா உறுதிப்பாடு பண்ணிங்கன்னா வச்சிங்க, இதெல்லாம் ஒரு மனுஷன்தான் அமெரிக்காவை உண்டாக்கியிருக்காரு, ஜார்ஜ் வாஷிங்டன் சொல்லிட்டு ஒரு மனுஷன் நினச்சி இவ்வளோ பெரிய அமெரிக்காவை உண்டாக்க முடிஞ்சால் நாம் ஏன் ஒரு சின்ன ஏரியாவை ஒரு அமெரிக்காவை உருவாக்க முடியாது? நீங்கள் உறுதியாக்குன்னு சொன்னால் நாங்கள் எல்லோருமே கூட இருந்து ஹெல்ப் பண்ண ரெடியாகும். நீங்கள் உண்மையிலேயே இதுக்கு சரிபட்டு வரணும். நீங்கள் வந்து இங்கேயே திருப்தி ஆகிடக்கூடாது. நீங்கள் கானா அப்படின்னு வச்சுருக்கீங்க, அதாவது கம்மாவார் அசோசியேஷன் நார்த் அமெரிக்கா, அதில் ஒரு அட்ராக்ஷன் இருக்குது என்னன்னா அமெரிக்கா ஒன்று தான். கம்மாவார் அசோசியேஷன் அது ஆயிரக்கணக்கில் இருக்குது தமிழ்நாட்டிலையும் இந்தியாவிலையும். நானே வந்து மதுரை தமிழ் மதுரை கம்மவார் சங்கத்துக்கு ஒரு 12-15 வருஷம் தலைவராக இருந்திருக்கேன். அதுபோக தமிழ்நாடு நாயுடு நாயக்கர் சங்கம்னு ஒரு பெரிய சங்கம் ஒன்று ஆரம்பித்தோம். அதுகள்லாம் வந்து ஒரு ஆரம்பித்த நிலையிலேயே போயிடுது. இது வந்து இப்போ ஆரம்பிச்சிருக்கீங்கன்னா ஒரு பெரிய லெவலில் கொண்டு போகுதுன்னா நீங்கள் வந்து தமிழ்நாட்டை ஒரு அமெரிக்காவை ஆக்க உறுதி கொள்ளணும், அந்த உறுதி ஏற்பாடு பண்ணுவீங்க நன்றி. நான் இந்த அமைப்புக்கு பேச நன்றி சொல்லிக்கொண்டு வணக்கம் வணக்கம்.
அண்ணா தேங்க்யூ.
அந்தரிக்கு வணக்கம். நான் வச்சு பாண்டியராஜ் தேனில் எண்ணாற்று நகரில் உண்டானேன். நான் ஏற்கனவே 1 மந்த்துக்கு முதல்ல இதே மாதிரி அமெரிக்க வச்சு தனி ப்ரோக்ராம் ஏற்பாடு செய்ய சொல்லிட்டு, ஆனால் ஈ காணா ப்ரோக்ராம் நான் தனிச்சு தான் தோசி பெட்டேசி டிக்கெட் கூட வேசுன்னு மாற்றேசி தினி ஒத்து தனி நின்ற சந்தோஷம் வந்து மீ அந்த சூச்சனை தனிச்சு இடம் இவரில் 200 பீப்புளில் வச்சு ஃபேமிலி வச்சு உண்டாருன்னு செப்து வருஷாணி ஒரு தடவை ஒரு ஒரு நீங்கள் 200 பீப்புள்ஸ் 200 பிணால் இடம் வச்சு பீல்ஸ் போகா வேலை வாய்ப்பு ஏற்பாடு செய்த வாழ அந்திரி சந்தோஷம் கொண்டு மன கம்மக்குலாணி போக மதிப்பு மரியாதை உண்டு. தனி மீறு அந்திரி ஏற்பாடு செய்யலாம். மீர் மட்டும் டெவலப் ஆகித்த சாலது அடுண்ட ஏழை வாழைகள் தான் கம்பானத்தை டெவலப் ஆகலாம். தனி மீர் அந்த சாலை ஏற்பாடு செய்யலாம். மற்ற அந்திரி நன்றி வணக்கம்.
நிண்டா தேங்க்யூ அண்ணா. பாமாட்டத்ரி நெக்ஸ்ட்டு துபாய் கேஎன்ஏ ஃபவுண்டர் விவிஎஸ் ராஜு அண்ணா வச்சி ரெண்டு மாட்ட மாட்டாடு மன தர.
I would like to invite Mama VVS Raju avargal Kanavin periya support KNA from Dubai because that's what you know we are here. I would like to talk.
Thank you Mabla. Andri namaskaram. Nan VVS Raju KNA ude mudal orunginippalar thalaivar ni seppane mudal orunginippalar na sonda ooru vachi Thoothukudi mavattam Ettayavaram pakkal ayan vadamalavaram but Dubai la vachi business chestunnane கோயம்புத்தூரில் செட்டில் ஆயினேன். அதாவது கம்மவார் நாயுடு அசோசியேஷன் வச்சு உலக லெவலில் 2012 ஆரம்பித்து ஏமேமி ஒரு 4-5 குறிக்கோள் அது மட்டும் நான் செப்பேசி நான் வரணும் முடித்தேன். மனதால் சிதறி கிடக்கும் நம் மக்களிடையே ஒற்றுமையை உண்டாக்குதல் நமது இன மக்களுக்கு பரஸ்பர உதவி மற்றும் ஊக்கப்படுத்துதல் நமது இன மக்களுக்கு மத்தியில் உறவை மேம்படுத்துதல் வறுமை கோட்டிற்கு கீழுள்ள நம் உறவுகளின் குழந்தை செல்வங்களுக்கு கல்வி கற்க உதவி செய்தல் வேலை தேடும் நம் இளைஞர்களுக்கு வேலைவாய்ப்பு வழிகாட்டுதல் உதவுதல் நம் இன மக்களுக்கு திருமண தகவல் கொடுத்தல் ஒன்லி சம்பந்தப்பட்ட தகவல் மட்டும் கொடுக்கப்படும் நம் இன பாரம்பரியம் கலாச்சாரத்தை பேணிக்காக்க நம் மக்களிடையே விழிப்புணர்ச்சியை ஏற்படுத்துதல் இங்கோன்னு செப்பேனு மீர் அமெரிக்காவில் உண்டாச்சும் ஈவன் கோயம்புத்தூர் சென்னையில் உண்டார் அட்லீஸ்ட் வருஷாணி ஒவ்வொட்டம் மன சொந்த ஊரி போய் அவன் ஐயா அம்மனு ஸ்டூடெண்டா இது செய்வன். இந்த விழாவிற்கு எங்களை கேஎன்ஏ சார்பாக என்னை அனுப்பி வைத்த எங்கள் கேஎன்ஏ ஆர்கனைசர் மெம்பர்ஸுக்கும் கானாவுடைய ஆர்கனைசர் மெம்பர்ஸ் அவர்களுக்கும் மிக்க நன்றி. இந்த விழாவை சிறப்பாக சக்ஸஸ்ஃபுல்லாக நடத்தி கொடுத்த உங்கள் அனைவருக்கும் இங்கே வந்திருந்து இந்த கானா என்ற குமார் நாயுடு நார்த் அமெரிக்கா என்ற பெயரை உலக அளவில் உச்சரிக்க செய்த உங்கள் அனைவருக்கும் எங்கள் கேஎன்ஏ சார்பாக நன்றியை தெரிவித்துக் கொள்கிறோம். நன்றி வணக்கம்.
Hello. கொஞ்சம் ஃபுட்டுன் வேஸ்ட் பண்ணுங்கண்டா, கிட்ஸுக்கு கொஞ்சம் ஹெல்ப் பண்ணுண்டா, ஃபுட் எத்தினது கொஞ்சம் ஃபுட் வேஸ்ட் பண்ணுங்கண்டா. ஃபுட் எத்தினங்களில் மீ டேபிள் போய் குச்சின் தின்னுடா, ஸோ தட் இட க்ரௌடு கொஞ்சம் கம்மியாகு. கொஞ்சம் கிட்ஸுக்கு மீர் ஹெல்ப் பண்ணுண்டா, மீர் எத்தியதையும் யூ கேன் கம் ஃபார் செகண்ட் சர்வ், பட் அளவுக்கு எடுத்துக்கொண்டா ஃபுட் வேஸ்ட் பண்ணுங்கண்டா. அதே மாதிரி ட்ராஷ் கேன்ஸ் உண்டாது, மீரு தினி முடிச்சிடங்களில் பிளேட்ஸ் அந்த வேணுது ட்ராஷ் கேன்ஸ் இடம் உண்டாது.